Welcome to episode one of Drive. Today, Alison's going to take Renault's formidable Mégane 225 for a spin, and we hot lap BMW's smoking M5. But we begin with an ending to a tale of an Aussie muscle car icon.
Once upon a time, in a strange and distant land, there was a very special car that was to be the last of its kind. One day, this car was brought before its elders and a guru.
In 1968, a piece of Australian automotive history was born, the Holden Monaro. It was the first product of Holden's then new Australian design studio, and the sleek but spacious two-door coupe won immediate press and public acclaim. But the Monaro wasn't just a pretty face. It kicked off its career in the best way possible, with a 1-2-3 finish at Bathurst. With one stroke, Holden had invented the segment for big Aussie coupes, and Ford and Chrysler rushed to follow them. It was a brief but brilliant career that lasted until 1978. Fast forward 20 years and Holden lobbed a bombshell with a two-door show car called the Commodore Coupe. And with huge public response to that car in 2001, it became a new Monaro. But even as I speak, the second coming of Monaro is drawing to a close, and this, the CV8Z, is going to be the last of its kind. Holden wants us to believe that this is an instant classic. Well, let's find out.
Would the last of the Monaros do honour to its mighty ancestors? Or would future generations choose not to mention it for shame? There was only one way to find out.
Now, the Monaro is no finicky French or taut Teutonic sports car. It's an Aussie muscle car. And first up, that means ergonomics to fit a front row forward. The seats are big and boofy, the steering's big and boofy, and slow geared, you've got to turn the wheel more than you'd expect. In fact, all of the control surfaces in the Monaro, the brake pedal, the throttle, the transmission, feels like there's a layer of sponge between you and what's really going on. Let's not forget the Monaro is a potent motor car, 5.7 litres, 260 kilowatts, 500 newton metres. This four-speed auto version will get from 0 to 100 in low 6-second bracket. The six-speed manual version does it in 5.8. Most everything about the Holden Monaro is big. Big engine, big performance, big wheels and tyres, big brakes. It's a blunt instrument. But hey, it's worth remembering, in this age of high-tech weaponry, you can still kill an animal with a rock.